Hey there guys, and welcome back to the channel. Welcome if it's your first time. In today's video, I'm reviewing the Truthear Nova Hybrid 5 Driver IEMs. Let's get it. What's cracking, audio fans? It's David here from Prime Audio Reviews. So here we've got the Truthear Nova. That's what the box looks like. It's a pretty attractive box. I kind of like that. There's a sneak peek at the frequency response graph on the back of the box. You get a pretty decent selection of ear tips inside, although all of them were too small for my ears. But you get this as well, and this is kind of nifty. So it's like this little zipper storage case. Quite nice. But the cool thing about it is it's got this belt clip on the other side. And yeah, I haven't seen that before, so kind of neat. But anyway, let's bring in these IEMs. And there they are. I think we'll start with the cable today, and it is a lovely blue and black fabric braided cable. Now, I'm not usually a fan of braided cables, but this one is very supple, so you can see it winds up nicely. It handles really well. Yes, it does have pretty aggressive ear hooks. I'm not a fan of those at all. They can cause a bit of discomfort for me over prolonged wearing. But yeah, the cable itself is pretty nice. Oh, by the way, this is longer than your standard cable. It's like at least about 20 centimeters longer than your average IEM cable. Not sure why that is. I don't hate it. I don't love it. I'm kind of give or take. But anyway, it's a nice cable. And it perfectly matches the blue color, the lovely blue color of the Truthear Nova. So that's what they look like. Kind of similar, well, similar pattern to the Truthear Zero Red, and I'll talk more about that IEM later. But the shell shape is different. I find these to be more comfortable. The nozzles aren't quite as wide as the Zero Red. Before we go any further though, let me tell you some facts about the Nova here. The price is $149. And it is a hybrid unit. It's got one dynamic driver and four balanced armature drivers per side. So we've got a bit of a penta driver thing going on there. All right, so let's throw up the graph. And that might look familiar to you, and there's a good reason for that. And long story short, the Truthear Nova is basically the Zero Red with a little bit of added treble. That's the simplest way to put it. In fact, you know what? I'm going to just throw up the comparison graph now. So the red line that you see there is the Truthear Nova. The black line, or the dark gray line, is the Truthear Zero Red. And you can see they're just very, very similar, right all the way up until 4 to 5 kilohertz. They both have an elevated sub bass. They both have a scooped out mid bass and lower mid range. So pretty lean in the lower mids, pretty lean throughout the mid range in general. And then you've got this rather forward, and I will say now shouty upper mid range. You can see even on the Nova here, it was already a little bit edgy on the Zero Red, but the Truthear Nova takes things a little bit further. It boosts that presence region up a bit, and yeah, definitely you get some shoutiness in those upper mids. So things like female vocals, particularly things I found like electric guitars, they can get pretty edgy pretty quickly. Thankfully, there's no sibilance really. It's just that bright upper mid range. They've sort of tamed the sibilance region down a little bit. Then it peaks up again like 8 kilohertz, and then it falls off quite drastically, but it comes up again later on. And it's interesting. I can see what they were kind of going for. They wanted to make the Zero Red, but you know, with a bit more better technicalities, like bigger sound stage, better detail retrieval. And in a sense they've done that, but at the same time, I don't know, it just doesn't work for me, this kind of tuning. And if you've watched a few of my videos before, you might be aware of that already, but I just find it unengaging, a bit pretentious, just a little bit shouty, a little bit lean. And the interesting thing about this one in particular is even though it's got a fairly significant sub-bass boost, it doesn't really hit that hard in the sub-bass. It doesn't really have that much authority in the very low frequencies. The mid-bass is as you would expect. It's nice and tight and controlled, and it doesn't bleed into the mid-range, but it doesn't have much impact either. It doesn't thump at all. Now, it does have very good vocal clarity, but like I said, can be shouty in the vocals, not grainy or anything, fairly smooth throughout the mid-range. The spacing, I would say, is decent, and the overall resolution is pretty good. It's not outstanding, but it's pretty good. I will say the detail retrieval is very good, the micro detail retrieval, so you will hear a lot of tiny little sounds that other IEMs might not pick up. But overall, I obviously, as you can tell, I'm just not a fan of this IEM. I think for the price, it performs reasonably well. I'm trying not to be subjective. I know I don't like this sound signature, and I'm trying to be objective about it. Like, it does have good detail retrieval. Resolution is just so-so, it's mediocre. Instrument separation is pretty good. And I am a fan of these shells. I like the color, I like that design, and the fit as well. So, and the cable, of course, like I mentioned, is a nice one. So that is the Truth Ear Nova. Look, I'm sure some people will enjoy it. If you like that Harman curve, then you'll probably be a fan of this one. Personally, it just doesn't do it for me, but it is how it is. Anyway, thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up, Parfam Audio File Style. If you're new here and you want to see more audio content like this, consider hitting that subscribe button before you go. And until next time, I'll see you later.